Here, and thank you very much on behalf of Cam H for the donation. We're going to do our best to entertain you this evening with duets and solos, thus the name of the event.
Should we clarify? I'm Lisa.
This is Lisa.
And this is Shael.
This is Shael. I'm not sure. Oh, do we have to fluff our hair? Is that what we have to do to start?
Yes. Yeah. Okay. Fluff?
Let's do it.
It falls.
Okay.
All good?
It worked for me. I don't know about you. I was desperate for it, so.
It's okay, I think.
All right, well, let's get started. How's everything? Everyone is can see us? Well, I'm asking cameras, so I don't know if anyone is going to respond to us, but certainly feel free to comment. If you want to post on the event page, do that as well. We're going to start with an old James Taylor song that he did originally with Joni Mitchell, and then later... With his wife's name, Carly Simon. I've only had a little bit to drink
just
so
a
far,
bit.
So anyway.
The original JT.
Mm-hmm. The OG JT.
JT.
Here's You Can Close Your Eyes. Where the audience claps that part.
Yeah.
This is weird.
It's really weird. I need
yeah.
it.
I know. Greg, you're gonna have to applaud after every song.
No, not just to,
yeah. No, no, that's good. That's good. No, it's if you imagine it, okay.
Pretty depressing.
If you imagine it, that's fine. Kai's come back in the room. We know it's
okay,
working
whoa.
Now. So now, yeah.
Thank
so now
you.
The two of them can clap. Okay. Good. All right, we got past the first one. That was good. All right. Next song we're going to do was written as a duet, which was great, by one of my favorite artists, certainly that got me through my late teens and early 20s angst, was Indigo Girls.
I didn't discover them until my late 30s.
Really?
Yeah.
That's interesting.
Yeah.
And I'm probably one of three guys who who were ever at their concerts. I was always by myself.
Did you go to Lilith Fair?
I went to Lilith Fair many times.
You did?
I did. Again, the only guy. I went with my sister. I went with my wife. But yeah, because I'm a Sarah McLachlan freak, I'm an Indigo Girls. It just is. I put up a lot of teasing, but at the end of the day, who the hell cares? It's good music.
Yeah.
Anyway, this is a good IG tune. It goes way back to 1989.
So Indigo Girls is the OG IG before Instagram.
Oh.
One could say.
Yeah, well, one could say if you're under 50. If you're over 50, I don't know what you just said. All right. Closer to Fine. Keeping score, I left out a verse, and Lisa had to stop singing it.
It's okay. You might have also said prostate.
I also said prostate instead of prostrate. This is the problem. When you're so used...
Hey, but we kept it together after
did.
That, didn't we?
We certainly
yeah,
did.
Yeah, we did.
That's the idea.
Yeah,
keep
we did.
Pushing through.
Cheers, friend.
Keep pushing through. That's the way it should work, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Like, again, if you came here for perfection, certainly by me, that ain't happening. So,
no, it's just charm here.
That's all. All right. So this song is actually this is a solo by Lisa. This song is actually one of the songs that Lisa and I have bonded to at 6 o'clock in the morning.
6 years ago.
Six years ago.
6 years ago.
At the tail end of the cast party for
August
Osage County. We were the last two standing. So I think Raisa was also standing. And
I mean,
Josh.
Probably also horizontal.
Josh Ford. Yeah. But anyway, that's a whole other story. But this is a Joni tune. And Lisa just, I mean, you just kill this song. So.
You can say that before I sing it.
Yes, I can.
It's like a lot of pressure.
I don't think that's going to be a whole lot of pressure for it. Anyways, this is River.
I made my so weird.
It's weird, right?
Does anybody like that? I don't know. Is that okay?
We're just going to assume that you're applauding and you're... It's very weird for attention...
Seeking actors?
Attention-seeking actors. Nice way of putting it. What do we call it? Attention whores?
Attention whores.
Isn't that what Mel calls it? Yeah, attention whores. Yeah, it's hard for attention whores not to get applause after playing, so just, we're going to imagine that that's what you're doing.
It's really hard for us, you guys.
Mm-hmm.
It's really hard.
It's really hard for us. All right. This one, under the subheading of amazing female vocalists, this one is originally a Melissa Etheridge song. It's been covered by a ton of people. But specifically, Lisa brought it to my attention as a duet between Melissa and Katie Lang. And it was absolutely fantastic. So we're going to give this one a run. This is You Can Sleep While I Drive. Come on, baby, let's get out of this town. I've got a full tank of gas with the top road down. There's a chill in my bones. I don't want to be left alone. So, baby, you can't sleep while I drive. So I'm going to do a solo.
Woo!
Let Lisa rest up. Let Lisa rest up a bit. This one never gets old for me to play. I love playing it, and it's probably one of the most requested songs that I do play. When you can give requests, so this one also goes all the way back to 1990. It's Walking in Memphis. right. Right. This one is, this one Lisa brought to the table too. It's more of an obscure or
I remember it from grade 8, 1992.
So, early 90s.
Early 90s.
And this was like the first, and maybe the only hit that this woman had, maybe?
It's the only song I know of hers.
It's probably because she was dating Don Henley, I'm assuming. Yeah.
It's always gone.
Yeah. That's how you get Don Henley on your track.
That's
yeah.
like the Linda Ronstadt, Aaron Neville thing.
There
I didn't know they were dating during that. They were.
Now we're just being mean. They could certainly take care of their own stuff and sing their own songs. All right. Yeah, this is a duet with Don Henley by Patti Smith. Different Patti Smith.
Mm-hmm.
And I had to transpose these ones, remember? Right, okay. Here we go. It's called Sometimes Love Just Ain't Enough. Look, I'm going old school.
Oh,
All right. My turn to do a Joni tune.
Maybe I should accompany you.
Yeah! That would be great! Have a drink first.
Mm-hmm.
At least I know.
Snaps.
All right. Are we seeing any comments or anything on that thing? I can't see.
There's so many comments.
Yeah, it's not going to
be. People are in love.
Is there a problem?
No.
Problem. Everyone can hear everything? Because we took out all of the electronic problems, and we're just doing it about as acoustic as it gets when you're dealing with digital technology. So, awesome. All right. So, there isn't really a place where Lisa and I can get together, and there's a piano, that someone doesn't make us play this song. So, we figure we might as well just go. We first did it for the One Brave Night concert. Back in 2019, before the darkness fell.
Before the darkness.
And it is one of a series of two Don Henley duets that we're doing.
Yep.
I wonder if it's because I have the exact same range as Don Henley.
Did he date Stevie Nicks?
Oh, yeah. She dated everybody. You don't say something about Fleetwood Mac and say, oh, did they date? Yes. The answer to,
yes.
Did this person date somebody in Fleetwood Mac? The answer is always yes. Yes. All right. This is Leather and Lace.
I knew you'd like my nights on.
Okay, something occurred to me while we were singing.
All right, what was that?
So, Stevie sings, "When you walked into my house, you won't be coming out the door."
Yeah.
Previously.
Uh-huh.
In Sometimes Love Just Ain't Enough.
Yeah.
Patti Smith said, "I keep seeing you walk through that door. Who keeps giving Don Henley their keys?" What is happening there?
That is an excellent point. Someone needs to write that down.
Don Henley needs to stop just coming in unannounced.
That's right. This is obviously a problem.
Doorbell.
This is obviously a problem. But you will notice that in rehearsal, I did always say that you were coming
in
my door.
House.
And I actually did it right this time.
Yes, so. You did. I noticed.
I just need to get as much, kudos and validation as I can for that. All right. This one, I mean, it's a beautiful song. And I say that I had to force Lisa to do it, but obviously it's a beautiful song and she would do it. But this is like a song that I always wanted to hear Lisa do. And so she kindly said, yes, take on.
Well, it's daunting.
It's a daunting song. It's daunting. Bonnie Raitt said it was daunting. Like, she stopped playing it live because it was emotionally crippling to her. Right? So that's why you should.
But I'm not emotional at all. It's fine.
Yeah, we'll see that later. But anyway, this is a great old tune from the late 80s, early 90s. I believe from the Luck of the Draw album. And it is called "I Can't Make You Love Me."
With piano by Bruce Hornsby. Mm. So the piano is gorgeous.
Well,
and you do it beautifully.
We're going to try and do it justice, right?
Now that we've hyped ourselves up.
We should just keep our mouths shut.
Nowhere to go but down.
We should just keep our mouths shut. Okay.
Inside.
lovely. Lovely.
You as well, sir.
Oh. All right. We're going to try and attack this one. You know, I shouldn't really put this, like, you know, in the bottom part of the set. In the back nine, as we like to call it.
Back nine.
Because I'm going to blow up my throat doing it. But, it's not like we're going live or anything like that. So.
No, it's not like there's people watching.
This is probably, I would imagine, in this set, one of the younger songs, and it's probably about 20 years old. So that'll tell you a little bit about...
That's true. The kind
of, oh, no, there's gravity.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah.
Mm.
And Ben.
Ah.
Right.
True, never mind. Disregard that. This one is by Train. This is a great song for piano players to play. Not a great song it's a hard song to sing, but we're going to give it a try. Thank you. some kind of heart monitor after that. All right. This is probably the youngest song on the show. But it's one of the most, as Elton John said, this is one of the most beautiful songs he's ever heard. He did this as a duet with Sarah Bareilles. But we like it as a solo.
Well, you like it. That makes it sound like I kicked Shael out of the duet.
No, you certainly didn't. I stepped out of the duet because there's a really... the part that Elton sings is extraordinarily low, and it's out of my range. So, it's not a duet anymore. All right. Gravity. I'd like to mess with Lisa, and that one beautiful note that she hits, I just don't come in until she gasps for breath.
Faint on the floor.
Because I thought it was funny. Anyway. Do we just sing this?
Yep.
Okay.
Fast, not slow.
All right, Lisa.
Yeah, we're just singing it. Let's plow through. Let's go.
Good morning, sun. I am a bird wearing a brown polyester shirt. You want a Coke? Maybe some fries? The roast beef combo's only $9.95. It's so afraid that we would have to cut away because she couldn't control herself, but she controlled herself. Because
it was a lullaby to Kai, and he's in the room.
Yeah.
You know, can I tell you
that
a secret?
That happened yesterday. It was
you
hilarious.
Have Jewel's book of poetry up there.
Yeah.
So I just stared at Jewel, thinking of my ridiculous Jewel voice. And I was like, what if I just start singing this song like Jewel? Like, good morning, sun.
Please don't. I always tried to get past her voice when I was listening.
I do a great Jewel.
I'm sure. All right, we're going to do a classic coming up on the end here, and then we're going to finish off with a Billy Joel tune, but we're going to do an Elton John tune.
You are.
Or rather,
you're
I am.
An Elton John tune.
Here's one that I want to hear you singing it with at home called Tiny Dancer. The tune she hung.
I'm gonna drive them crazy and mess up their camera.
Uh-oh.
We got Gregory Miles Watt and Kai Ferreira, the son of Good Morning Sun.
Someone has to...
Okay, where do you want it?
Go back to where you are.
Okay, sorry. But they're doing a great job.
They sure are, until Lisa moved the camera.
I feel like it's important.
I agree. I agree. This is one of my favorite, and probably one of the most obscure Billy Joel songs.
I did not know this song.
Mm-hmm. And I would say that most people don't. It doesn't get a whole lot of airplay, but...
It's great. I'm obsessed with it now.
Yeah, it's it was written with the Righteous Brothers in mind, and you'll know when we sing it why. And he actually does all the harmonies in it, but... If you know the Righteous Brothers, you know that one had a beautiful low voice and one had a beautiful high voice. So he had to do both, and we're going to try and get and do that here as well. This is a great song, and I've always wanted to do this live, so here we go. It's called Until the Night.
Until the night,
closing it down. I'm going to open it up, and while they're going to sleep, we'll just be starting to talk.
I'm just beginning to feel. I'm just beginning to give. I'm just beginning to feel. I'm just beginning to live. Before I need you again, before the light of the dawn, before this evening can end, I have been waiting so long.
Months of this, and Lisa squeezed this into like a million shows that she's doing, so it's appreciated. And all of you who donated tonight, certainly, if you still haven't donated, I'm not sure how you're watching this, but if you still haven't donated, feel free to go to the link on the event page that takes you to the CAMH site, where you can make any donation you want to make. It's completely everything goes to CAMH, and it is so worthy a cause there, especially during and after the pandemic, people's mental health has been so critical that it's been hard for them to keep up with. So please give generously. Thank you all so much. Thank you to Greg and Kai and everyone who helped out with this. I hope you enjoyed it.
Good night.
See you later.